So welcome again to this particular session. 2.3 we will take up to commence this one. Correct. So 2.23 is the question which we are picking up. 2.23. Now in this question, what is given to us? 777 of Hyderabad has a branch at Warangal and all the purchases are made by the head office and goods sent to branch are invoiced at selling price which is 20% above cost. So goods are sent which is 20% above cost. Although I need not require to do this, but still I will do for you. Cost price plus margin is equal to selling price or invoice price. Rate is based upon cost. So cost will be taken as 100, margin 20, selling price 120. Rate of profit on cost will be equal to 1 by 5 and 20 by 120, that is 1 by 6 on sales. Now, question states that brand stock at invoice price is 36,000. You can start doing it this particular question of your own. Opening stock 36,000. And then towards the branch adjustment account, you will write here load on opening stock. Now opening stock is 36,000 into 1 by 6. So 6,000 will be your loading on opening stock. Branch debtors opening balance is given to you. That is 25,750. So in the branch debtors account, you will write here balance brought down 25,750. Then we have in this case transactions during the year, goods sent to branch at invoice price is this much. Just allow me to So goods sent to branch at invoice price. Goods sent to branch account at invoice price is 3,24,600. Loading, load on goods sent to branch account 324,600 into 1 by 6. So what will be the amount of loading? 324,600 divided by 6, 54,100. So 54,100 is your loading amount. Correct? 54,500 is your loading amount. Then we have been given, besides that, return from head office, return from branch to head office 6420. So goods sent to branch account return, we shall write over here in the branch stock account. We'll write here returns 6420. And then we will take the loading. Load on. Goods sent to branch returns 6420 into 1 by 6. Pretty clumsy figures. So 6420 divided by 6 is equal to 1070. 1070. Correct? 1070. Then we have here cash received from debtors 3,10,000. So in the debtors account, we will write simply by cash. We have received cash from debtors. So I will write here 3,10,000. Besides that, cash received from debtors, then we have discount allowed to debtors 5,750. Discount, again, it will figure in debtors account. 5750. And discount will also find place towards the debit side of branch P&L account 5750. Next item which is given to us is branch expenses paid by head office, and that is 30,000. So branch expenses. Branch expenses 30,000. So far this question seems very, very simple. And branch debtors 10,000. Closing balance given to you, balance carried down 10,000. In this question, closing balance of branch debtors is given to you, closing debtors. And then we have closing balance of stock. So in the branch stock account, we shall write 48180, closing stock. Closing stock is 48180. And then I will write loading also, loading on closing stock 48180 into 1/6. Very, very clumsy figures, as I have already told you. It is 48180 divided by 6, it is 8030. 8030. Then here in the question, it is given all the branch sales are on credit terms. All sales are on credit terms, so no question of any cash sales. Now everything is over. So what we are supposed to do first in this particular question, credit sales are not given to us. Quite obviously, we shall have to find out credit sales. So in order to find out your credit sales, you will tally this account and you will have to find the amount of credit sales. Now what will be your credit sales? Credit sales, balancing figure. So even in this question, because credit sales were not given, so we may say that relevancy of branch debtors is quite high, 3 lakhs. So now we have the credit sales, rest of the things should be very, very easy. Credit sales. So you have found out credit sales. Now you tally both sides to know whether there is surplus or what we call deficiency. In this question, according to your solution, we have deficiency. Debit side is bigger. So deficiency, loading, sorry, deficiency, spoilage or shortage. Whatever you may like to write, you can write. Deficiency, balancing figure, 6,000. Now, loading on deficiency. Deficiency is 6,000 into 1/6. 1,000 will be your loading. And deficiency at cost, first you must write. Deficiency at cost. -1,000. So deficiency at cost will be equal to 5,000. Now you will tally your branch adjustment account to know whether you have, in this case, gross profit or not. So in this case, you have gross profit to the extent of 50,000. So you shall write your gross profit. Balancing figure. Gross profit will be taken to the credit side of branch P&L account. Gross profit 50,000. From there on, you will subtract all these items to find out your final profit 9250. 9250 according to your solution. Branch debtors account is already closed. So in this question, actually, just to make you aware of the fact that sometimes debtors play important role even in this methodology. Now 2.24 is an interesting question. Just pay attention. 2.24 question states that Manager's commission, first of all, the title of the question is managerial commission. Now, in this question, what is happening? Let me first explain the question. Correct? And in order to explain this particular question, manager's commission, a head office at Mumbai has a branch at Chennai in charge of a manager. Head office is in Mumbai, branch is at Chennai, and of course that branch is in charge of a manager. That means one manager has taken the charge of that particular branch. Further, it is given ratio of gross profit on turnover at the branch is 25% constant throughout the year. What does indirectly it means? Indirectly, it means in this particular question, the ratio of gross profit on the turnover. Turnover basically stands for selling price. We will see later on. Selling price, we always consider it as invoice price. So selling price, this time rate is based upon selling price. We will consider selling price as 100. And our profit margin, or simply margin, will be equal to 25%, and our cost price will be equal to 75. So we may say in this particular question that rate of profit on selling price is 25/100, that is 1/4, and on cost price it will be equal to 25/75, 1/3. Branch manager is entitled to a commission of 10%. Pay attention towards this line. We have an agreement with the branch manager, and often actually head office enters into such sort of strategy that we will pay you some commission so that branch manager works with greater zeal and enthusiasm. In fact, that is the actually idea behind such contracts. The branch manager is entitled to a commission of 10%, but subject to a deduction from such commission is sum equal to 50% of any ascertained deficiency of branch stock. Now, what is the contract between the head office and the branch manager? Head office has asked branch manager that we shall give you 10% commission, no doubt about that. Indirectly, it means if you are going to work more, if you are going to earn or fetch us more return, obviously, because you are being entitled to some commission. So if the profit will be enlarged, your commission too will be a little bit high. So we have given our words to the branch manager that we are going to offer you 10% commission. But at the same time, we have put up a rider. We have put up a condition. The condition is that in case if there would be any deficiency at your site, then 50% of that deficiency will be subtracted from your commission. Now, this condition or rider has been kept perhaps due to the fact that a branch manager should work with, as I said earlier, with not only zeal and enthusiasm, but with caution and care that there should not be any deficiency. That means as much as possible, they should try to do what we call sale of the goods and try to increase the profits for us. So the contract here is that we will give you 10% commission. And in case if there would be any deficiency, 50% of the deficiency will be subtracted from your commission. All the goods were supplied to the branch by the head office. From the following figures extracted from the branch books, calculate the commission due to the manager for the year ended 31st December 2022. Now, here in this particular question, you have been given a stock at cost 90,000. Now, stock at cost is given, and this is at 90,000. Because stock at cost is given at 90,000, so obviously I will have to turn it to invoice price. In order to turn it to invoice price, I will have to apply the rate of 1/3. Similarly, goods received from head office is given and no goods in transit is given. That means goods received and goods sent to branch are one and same thing in this question. However, again, it is at cost price. Again, I will have to convert it to invoice price. Then sales are 4 lakh. Because in this question, there are no opening daters and closing daters, so we can conclude that sales are all cash sales. Then further, you have been given in this particular question, where is the mouse? Sometime it flicks. That is the basic problem. Right, here it is. So, now the next item is sales 4 lakh, as I told you. Establishment expenses are there. which will be put towards the debit side of profit or loss account. Now this line, drawings by manager against commission, what does it mean? Drawings by manager against the commission. Because manager is already aware of the fact that this time he is entitled to 10% commission. He knows that something will accrue to the manager as what we call commission. So he might have asked for some advance against that commission, because branch manager knows that he has to take commission from the head office. So he has withdrawn some amount against that commission. Indirectly, it means it is a sort of advance commission, because he has already drawn some amount to the extent of 1,000. That means 1,000 worth of commission we have given him in advance. Opening, and besides that, we have got closing stock, but closing stock is given at selling price. That means it is given at invoice price. This is the question. Now, what is the demand of this particular question? Actually, the demand of the question is calculate the commission due to the manager. Here it is. Calculate the commission due to the manager for the year ended so and so. Actually, this is the only demand of the question. This is date. Take care of 1/4/2022, and closing date is 31/12/2022. So now we can solve this particular question, correct? So in order to solve this particular question, this is 2.24. First of all, let me write here rates analysis. Which I have already done for you, cost price plus margin is equal to selling price, which is nothing but invoice price, because this time rate is based upon selling price. So selling price will be taken as 100, margin will be 25, cost will be 75. So 1/3 rate of profit on cost, 1/4 rate of profit on sales. Now the first item which I was talking about you, which I was talking a bit earlier, sorry. So opening stock is given to you at 90,000, correct? So I will write opening stock. Opening stock. Now opening stock at cost is given to you. That is 90,000. It is at cost. So what I will do, I will apply the rate of profit on cost, which is 1/3, 30,000. So invoice price or selling price of opening stock must be equal to 1,20,000, because this account is always prepared at selling price or invoice price, whatever you may say. And now after finding out the loaded portion, we will write here load on opening stock. That is 1,20,000. Now it is selling price or invoice price. So I will apply the rate 1/4. However, the amount of loading will be same, 30,000. You can straight away write 30,000. There is no need to reflect it in this manner. Then goods received from head office. So goods received, that is actually goods sent to branch account, because whatever goods have been received must have been sent by the head office, because there is no goods in transit. So it is given to you again at cost, so you will write at cost 3 lakh. Again, you will add 1/3. That is 1 lakh. So total will be equal to 4 lakh. And then loading on goods sent to branch account. That is 4 lakh into 1/4, that is equal to 1 lakh. Then we have been given sales. So in the branch stock account, I am going to write sales by sales. In fact, these are cash sales. Sales in this case is equal to 4 lakh. Then we have establishment expenses. Establishment expenses are equal to 10,000. So establishment expenses you are going to write to the debit side or profit and loss account. Establishment expenses that is equal to 10,000. After the establishment expenses, now we have in this case drawings by manager against commission. Drawings by manager against commission, how we will deal with that, I will let you know after a while. Closing stock given to you now is equal to 1 lakh. Closing stock, 1 lakh. I will write here balance carried down or closing stock simply. Now closing stock given to you at selling price, 1 lakh. Now, I will write here loading on closing stock 1 lakh into 1 by 4. That is equal to 25,000. Till up to this particular point of time, we do not have deficiency, and in this question we need to find the amount of deficiency, because it was written in the prefacing line that in case if there would be any deficiency, 50% of that amount will be subtracted from your commission. So your total is 520 minus 5 lakhs, so deficiency towards this side I will write. So amount of deficiency, now you can write here deficiency. Now this is deficiency, no doubt about that, and it is equal to 20,000. So you have been able to extract the figure of deficiency, number one. Now write deficiency at cost, loading on deficiency. First you write 20,000 into 1 by 4, 5,000. Then deficiency at cost in the P&L. Deficiency at cost will be equal to 15,000, 20 minus 5. Now I will compute the gross profit. 1 lakh 30 minus 30, my gross profit is equal to 1 lakh in this case. Right, gross profit is 1 lakh. Now you write gross profit towards the credit side of P&L, 1 lakh. Now, at this particular point, if suppose I am going to ask you from 1 lakh, if I am going to subtract, let us say from 1 lakh, if I am going to subtract 25,000, what will be my profit? This is 75,000. This is my profit, or this is the profit at this moment before commission. Correct? Now, the main point of the question was computation of commission due. See here, workings in the working notes, what I will have to do. Manager's commission. How much will be the manager's commission now? You have the net profit. So manager's commission as per your contract will be 10% of the net profit, because it is simply given that you would be given 10% commission. Obviously, it means 10% of net profit, isn't it or not? Manager was entitled to a commission of 10%. So, because my net profit at this moment is 75,000, so commission actually will be, commission was 20%, or in this case 10%. Manager is entitled to a commission of 10%. Actually, you just rectify, it is 20%. I think there is some misprint. Anyway, no problem. Whatever percentage is given in the question, you simply apply here. So, presuming that manager's commission is 20%, I made it 20% so that it strikes with the what we call answer. That's all. So if 20% I will compute 75,000, his commission comes to 15,000. Correct? Supposing that manager is given 20% commission instead of 10%, which we were talking about earlier. So 20% commission, 20% of 75,000 is 15,000, no doubt. But in this question, there is deficiency also. And as per the contract, 50% of the deficiency shall be subtracted from the commission. So less 50% of deficiency. Now, sometime a confusion may arise among the student that should we pick deficiency as 20,000? Because from branch stock account, we drove out deficiency to the extent of 20,000. So you may be tempted to think that 50% of 20,000 should be subtracted. But my advice to you is, actually there is a controversy regarding that. Instead of taking deficiency at invoice price, always take deficiency at cost. Correct? Why? Because in the profit and loss account, we write deficiency at cost. So whatever item is written in the profit, that is affecting the net profit. So that is the reason it is better to take 50% of deficiency at cost. Now deficiency at cost we computed is 15,000. So that is equal to 15,000 into 50%. 50% of that will be subtracted. So I will subtract 7,500. So it means now we are supposed to give 7,500 to the manager. However, we are supposed to give 7,500, no doubt. But he has already drawn 1,000 rupees. I told you I will explain it later. Now I am coming to that particular point. So now again I will subtract, and here I will write drawings against. Drawings against commission. So drawings against commission means he has already drawn some amount against the commission because he knew that he would receive some commission. Drawings against commission. So drawings against commission is 1,000. He has already withdrawn 1,000 rupees. That means we are supposed to give him 6,500. In fact, we can end the solution here itself because now we have given the answer which the examiner is seeking from us. This is commission due. Ultimately, we are supposed to provide how much commission is due. So commission amount due will be 6,500. Correct. However, if you want to reflect it in your P&L, you write here commission, manager's commission. Manager's commission. Paid. Actually, paid means drawings against commission. Drawings against commission. Instead of paid, you can write drawings against commission also. So 1,000, it means you have already paid, and outstanding that is due as per your working note is 6,500. So total commission, total manager's commission 7,500 will be reflected. You have already paid 1,000, 6,500 is yet to be paid. And now whatever you get will be your net profit. So your net profit will be 67,500. 67,500 will be your net profit. This is how you will solve this particular question. It's an interesting one, no doubt about that. Correct? Now, after finishing this one, we move over to 2.25, and this question again is quite interesting. Looks simple, but very interesting. 2.25. In 2.25, question states Messrs. 9 O'Clock Limited of City Y opened a branch. So first of all, it is a new branch. And goods are sent to the branch at selling price, which is cost plus 25%. At selling price, which is cost plus 25%, what does it mean? Rates, cost price, margin, invoice price. Rate is based upon cost 100, margin 25, this is 125. On invoice price, rate will be 1 by 5, on cost, it will be 25 by 100, 1 by 4. Now, question states that goods are sent to branch at cost to head office. That means this item is at cost. So I will have to convert this item to invoice price, which I will do. No doubt about that. So I will write here opening goods sent to branch account. No question of opening stock because this is newly opened branch. Goods sent to branch account. At cost is given to us 2,80,800. I will take the rate on cost, which is 1 by 4. I will apply 1 by 4 to it. 2,80,800 divided by 4, it is equal to 70,200. 70,200. If I add 70,200 plus 2,80,800, that comes to 3,51,000. That means in the current year, 3,51,000 worth of goods at invoice price were sent by head office to the branch, correct? We can write the loading also if you are interested. Load on goods sent to branch account. You can straight away write 70,200, or you can reflect it 3,51,000 into 1 by 5. And if you will compute, then the amount will be 70,200 only. Correct? 70,200. Now, after that, in this question, we have been given cash sales and credit sales. No problem. Cash sales, 1,25,000. Cash sales, 1,25,000. Then we have credit sales, 1,75,000. Credit sales, 1,75,000. 1,75,000. Obviously, if you are preparing branch debtors account, you will also write your credit sales over here. No question of opening debtors. It's a newly opened branch. 1,75,000. Correct? This is very interesting question. Looks simple. And I'm going to ask you something later on. Cash collected from debtors. Next item is given 1,56,000. So cash collected 1,56,000. I will write 1,56,000. And then next item which you have here is discount allowed to debtors. Discount allowed to debtors 4,000. Again, I will have to move to debtors account to write it discount allowed 4,000. Of course, discount allowed will be written in the P&L account. So in the P&L, I will write discount that is equal to 4,000. Now the next item is these three items, wages, freight and other expenses. We can put them into P&L. 3 plus 11, 14 plus 6, 20,000. We can straight away write expenses, or if you want to show them separately, you can. Otherwise, you can straight away write. Wages, 3,000. Freight, 11,000. And then other expenses. Other expenses are 6,000. Correct. Then we have been given here a spoilage written of 500. Spoilage, you know, stands for deficiency. So spoilage is already given to you. Spoilage, that is 500. Then you will move over to the debit side of branch adjustment. You will write here load. You will write here spoilage. That is 500 into 1 by 5, that is 100, and then 400 in the branch P&L. Spoilage at cost. Spoilage at cost 400, 500 minus 100. then you have been given closing stock 55,500. Closing stock 55,500. Here you will write load on closing stock 55,500. Correct, 11,100. Now everything is over in this particular question. Now I will come over to a very interesting point. If you will total this, it will be equal to 3,56,000. That means balancing figure we are getting over here. So balancing figure is actually 5,000. What you should consider this time. My question to you is, because whenever balancing figure appears towards the debit side, as a rule, the first preference is given to opening stock. However, in this question, opening stock cannot be possible because it is a newly opened branch. Second preference is always given to goods sent to branch account. Goods sent to branch account is already there, so we cannot treat this as goods sent to branch. Third preference is given to surplus. Yes, so we should consider this as surplus. No, in this question we cannot consider it as surplus also, because in a same question you cannot have a spoilage and surplus, because spoilage also means deficiency. In the same question you cannot have deficiency and surplus, so that is the reason, because spoilage is given, I cannot treat it as surplus also. So I will be left off with no other alternative, and I will have to treat it as sales return, because this is the only other item which falls towards the debit side. So that is why I said that this question is quite interesting. So sales return, you will consider this figure, and I have written this in your notes, or I might have written it in somewhere, correct? So sales return you will consider it, and sales return you will have to write in the branch debtors account also. 5,000. So this is the main point of this particular question. Rest of the things are very easy. And then you will tell your branch adjustment account from where you will get your gross profit to the extent of 59,000. And then you will take the gross profit 59,000. And from there on you will subtract all these items to get your net profit. And net profit is 34,600. And then finally your debtors account and balance carried down will be equal to 10,000. So this was the point, and here I have written in this question. In this question, credit side is bigger, and hence balancing figure shall appear on the debit side, which cannot be taken as opening stock as it is a new branch, or surplus as spoilage is given. Correct, and spoilage and surplus cannot coexist. Thus, only alternative left is to consider it as sales return. So we have given this one as a note also. And the next question is, from your past examination, this question has been taken. Messrs. 11 O'Clock Limited of City Y opened a branch at City X on 1st of April 2021, and goods are sent to the branch at selling price, which is 125% of the cost price. Now, some of the students may get confused while computing the rates of this particular question. 2.26. Now, in this question, it is given that goods are sent to branch at selling price, which is 125% of the cost price. Because rate is based upon cost, I can consider cost as 100. Goods are sent to branch at selling price, which is 125% of the cost price. Cost price plus margin is equal to selling price or invoice price Question this time has stated that selling price is 125% of the cost price. 125% of the cost price. It means if cost is 100, selling price is 125% of cost. That is 125. So margin will be equal to 25. So 1 by 5 on selling price or invoice price will be the rate, and 1 by 4 on cost will be your rate. The rest of the question I need not require to do because it is manageable question. You can easily manage it. Goods sent to branch at cost is given to you. Because goods sent to branch at cost is given to you, so you will write here goods sent to branch, and it is a newly opened branch. So no question of opening stock. So 4,50,000, this is at cost, and you will compute 1/5, which will be 90,000. So that means you must have sent 5,40,000 worth of goods at invoice price. Correct? And then while preparing the branch adjustment account, you will write here load on goods sent to branch account 5,40,000 into 1 by 5, that is 90,000. Then you have in this particular case cash and credit sales. Cash sales is 2,10,000. Cash sales 2,10,000. Credit sales. Amount of credit sales is 3,20,000. 3,20,000. And credit sales will be written in the debtors account also. So credit sales 3,20,000. Then we have here cash collected from debtors 2,85,000. Again in the debtors account I will write by cash 2,85,000. Then we have in this particular question returns from debtors 10,000, sales return 10,000. Because we are preparing branch stock account, sales return will also be written over here. Returns from debtors, returns from debtors is over. Discount allowed to debtors is 8,500 now. Discount allowed. In branch P&L account, discount allowed. Correct? And then we have got in this case your these expenses. So I will write in freight 38 plus 12, 50,000. I will straight away write here. In the P&L account, expenses 50,000. And then we have here spoilage. Once again, is given in the question. Spoilage is 10,000. You write here load. Spoilage $10,000 into 1/5 $2,000, and spoilage at cost will be written in branch P&L account. So you will write here spoilage at cost $8,000. 10,000 minus 2,000. Then in this question, we have normal loss estimated at 15,000. We can either simply ignore it or if at all you want to show, you will have to write normal loss first towards the credit side. Then full amount of normal loss you will have to debit to branch adjustment account. Normal loss. That is equal to 15,000. Now in this question, which if I am going to tally this one, 5,50,000 is the total. From 5,50,000, if I will subtract, just ₹2,10,000 plus ₹3,20,000. Credit sales is equal to ₹3,20,000 and plus 10, 210, 320 plus 10 plus 15. Slightly normal loss is your 15,000, correct? Just allow me a second. What was the amount of sales return? 10,000, fine. 540, 320, 330, 340. Well, it seems actually some mistake in these solution hints are because your credit side total is coming more, correct? Credit side total is more in this particular question. And I have analyzed everything. We have incorporated all the items. So your credit side total is higher. It will be equal to 210 plus 320 plus 25. That is 5,55,000. Credit side total is higher. 5,55,000. So in this question, you will now again the question is, because this item cannot be treated as opening stock, just wait, it seems I have committed some mistakes somewhere. What were the rate of profit on cost? Rate of profit on cost was 1/4. This is the mistake. Extremely sorry. Please take it as 1/4. That is why I was wondering how come it is possible. 4,50,000 divided by 4. So this item will be equal to 1,12,500. 1,12,500, and it will be equal to 5,62,500. 5,62,500. And your loading will be 5,62,500 into 1/5. 1,12,500. So now we can say that this particular side is bigger and total will be, let me compute, 5,72,500. And from 5,72,500, calculator is creating problem, minus 5,30,000, minus 25,000, 17,500. So in this question, now we are getting balancing figure of 17,500 towards this side. Obviously, we will have to treat it as closing stock because it is not given and the first preference is given to closing stock. Correct? Total is 5,72,500. 17,500 is your closing stock. Now you will take the closing stock, loading of closing stock, 17,500 into 1/5. 17,500 divided by 5 is equal to 3,500. Now I will compute my gross profit. 1,12,500 minus 2,000 minus 3,500 minus 15,000. 92,000, right? Yes? 92,000. Question was simple, no doubt, but we committed a mistake in the initial stages. Gross profit 92,000. And from gross profit 92,000, I will subtract 8,500, 58,000. 25,500, correct? This is your net profit. And if you want to tally your debtors account, balance carried down 16,500. So this is how you will have to do this particular question. It unnecessarily consumed our 5 minutes extra. Next one is 2.27. Just pay attention. Cliffs and Company operates a branch at Chandigarh and all the purchases are made by the head office in Delhi and goods are charged at selling price, which is cost plus 50%. Goods are charged at selling price, which is cost plus 50%. What does it mean? It means cost price, margin, selling price. Rate is based upon cost, margin 50, selling price 150, 1/2 rate of profit on cost, 1/3 on selling price. First thing first. And then question states that branch expenses are to be borne by head office. Branch maintains only sales ledger and subsidiary books, but otherwise all branch transactions are recorded in the books of the head office. In the beginning of the accounting year, 1/4/2020, at branch there was stock worth ₹2,76,900. So you will take the loading of this item at 1/3. This is at invoice price. Opening debtors are 54,800. You can write it easily. See here, I have written opening stock 2,76,900 and we have taken its loading. Loading is 2,76,900 into 1/3. Similarly, opening debtors have been put in the debtors account. This is your debtors account and 54,800 we have written over here, correct? Then in this question, we have goods receipt. That is nothing but goods sent to branch account because no goods in transit is given. So you will write here goods sent to branch account 9,37,200 in the branch stock account. And then you will write here loading on goods sent to branch account 9,37,200 into 1/3. That is equal to 3,12,400. Then we have in this case cash and credit sales. So you will write in the branch stock account and credit sales. And credit sales you will also write in the debtors account, 4,23,700. Then we have goods returned to head office. That is 14,400. So towards the credit side of the branch stock account, we will write 14,400, and we will take the loading of this. We will write here loading on goods sent to branch account 14,400 into 1 by 3. 4,800 will be loading. Then agreed allowances to customers. See, allowances to customer, if it is written, I explained this point in an earlier question also, if I remember distinctly. Allowances to customer always means discount. So discount to customer, and that is why allowances to customer you are going to write over here. I have written discount allowed. You can write allowances also. Allowances to customer is nothing but discount allowed to customer. Sometime it is written allowances of selling price. If it is written allowances of selling price, so agreed allowances to customer this time is given. Sorry. Agreed allowances to customer. If it is given agreed allowances to customer at selling price, you must write here selling price. See, if it would have been written allowances to customer, it would have come in the debtor's account. Correct? Actually, it must be agreed allowances to customer at selling price or off selling price. Off selling price. Whenever it is written allowances to customer off selling price, then it is considered as normal loss. Then it is considered as normal loss. If it is written allowances to customer of selling price, first you write here agreed allowances to customer of selling price, OFF, of selling price. Then it is considered as normal loss. So it will come in the branch stock account and of course towards the debit side of the branch adjustment account. Suppose if it would have been written allowances agreed allowances to customers. Suppose if it would have been written allowances to customers. Allowances to customers. Suppose if it would have been written this way around, in that case I would have treated as discount allowed and I would have had credited it to branch debtor's account. So here you have to be quite cautious whenever word allowances is written. If simply allowances is written, always treat it as discount, put it towards the credit side of debtors. If it is written allowances to customer, then also you need to put it to the credit side of debtors account. However, if it is given in this manner, agreed allowances to customer of selling price, actually there is misprint. So of selling price it is, agreed allowances to customer of selling price, then treat it as normal loss. And then once you are going to write it to the credit side of your branch stock account, and also you will take it to the debit side of your branch adjustment account. Correct? Cash receipt from debtors will be written in the debtors account, and of course discount allowed will also be written to the disc. So in this question, discount allowed is given separately. Let me So discount allowed 9,700 and cash received from debtors is this much. Even bad debts 4,800 will come here. And discount and bad debts you are also going to write to the debit side of your P&L account. Correct? Then you have been given expenses 1,43,800. So expenses 1,43,800. What else is given in the question? On 31st of March 2021, at the end of current accounting year, closing stock is 2,45,100. You will write closing stock. You will take the loading. 2,45,100 into 1 by 3. 81,700. This is how you are going to solve this question. And then you will tally this. You will get what we call your shortage. You will write the loading on shortage 567, correct? That is 1,700 into 1 by 3. Then shortage at cost, you will write in your branch P&L account. Here you have written it. And then finally, you will get your net profit. And when you will prepare your debtors account, you will get 65,400 as the amount. 2.28 is quite an interesting question. First, you must give it a try by yourself if possible. Correct? And you can do it. That doesn't mean that you can't do it. Kenstar Limited has a branch at Chandigarh and Gwalior. You have to keep track of the fact that which branch question is asking you to do the accounting for. So following information is available with respect to Chandigarh branch. So in this case, Chandigarh branch accounting you will have to do. Opening balances are given, no need for me to discuss anything. Only thing is that in this case, you better prepare petty cash account also. You prepare petty cash account also, and in the petty cash account, you write opening balance 150. Because this time petty cash is also given. Transactions during the year is given to you. Goods sent to branch 420, you can manage. Goods return, you can manage. Cash sales, credit sales, you can manage. Normal loss, you know the treatment. Branch stock account credit side, branch adjustment debit side. Goods pilfered, you treat it as both these items should be treated as abnormal loss. Goods pilfered and lost in fire. Correct? You can directly take abnormal loss. 7,000, 3 plus 4, 7,000 towards the credit side or branch stock account, and then take the loading to the debit side of branch adjustment account, and then abnormal loss at cost, you simply debit it to your profit or loss account. Insurance claim admitted. Insurance claim admitted, take it to the credit side of P&L. Credit side of P&L. Cash sent for petty expenses. This was the point I was trying to tell you. Because this time I have asked you to prepare petty cash account. So whatever cash we have sent, we will write in the petty cash account to cash, and petty cash expenses 32,000 rupees we have sent. Head office has sent to branch 32. So in the petty cash account, you write to cash. Then bad debts 400 is there. You know the treatment of bad debts. Debtors account and P&L account. Goods transferred to Gwalior branch. See here, this time you are Chandigarh branch. And you have transferred the goods. So, write it to the credit side of branch stock account. And also take the loading. Because this time you are transferring the goods. So, goods available with you will get reduced. So, you will have to credit the branch stock account. And also take the loading to the debit side. Now, insurance charges 200 is normal expense. You can debit it to profit and loss account. Goods returned by debtors. Goods returned by debtor once in debtors account, second in branch stock account. Now, balances at the end is given. Petty cash. See here, petty cash balance carried down is 250. So, the difference you simply put to the debit or profit and loss account. Difference shows the amount is spent. Now, in this method, we are more concerned with the amount spent. Whatever amount is spent, that will be written to the debit side of profit and loss account. Correct? Then debtor's closing balance 11,000 is given. Closing balance of stock you will find once you prepare the stock account. And just to confuse you, he has written goods transferred to Gwalior branch are still in transit. So those goods which you have, that means Chandigarh branch has transferred, are still in transit. So it is not going to make any difference. Only thing is that when you will write here goods transferred to Gwalior branch, also write in bracket goods transferred to Gwalior branch is still in transit. Correct? Just to make the examiner understand that we have picked up the point which you want to tell to us. So this is how you are going to do the question. Opening stock 40,000, goods sent 4,20,000, sales return is given, cash credit sales, goods sent to branch returns, normal loss is there, abnormal loss 3,000 plus 4,000, 7,000, goods transferred you write here in transit also. Because those goods which you have transferred are still in transit. Your balancing figure will be this much, you can manage this question, isn't it or not? And this is your branch adjustment account, this is your what we call gross profit, finally your net profit, and I think this question is quite manageable. So, anyway, you try to do this question, and once you are done up with question number 2.28, also try to do question number 2.29. There is nothing that you haven't done anything, so you don't require any sort of what we call in this case guidance. I'm sure that if you are going to give it a try, you can definitely succeed in doing this one. Anyway, till that time, we take leave of you and shall meet you in the next session. We'll be right back.